Hello children, welcome back to our maths class. Today we shall continue with the chapter triangles. So now children, open your book to page number 36, textbook page number 36. Okay, now let us recall, what do you mean by a median? So let's see, in triangle ABC, you can see a figure is shown. Okay, now the figure in triangle ABC, the segment joining a vertex, okay, you can see a segment which joined the vertex A and the midpoint of side BC. So D is a midpoint of side BC. So in triangle ABC, a line joining the vertex and the midpoint of side BC is called the median of the triangle. So segment AD is called as the median of the triangle. Okay, so what is median? Median is a segment joining the vertex and the midpoint of the side opposite to the vertex. Okay, that is called as the median. Next, let us see, what do you mean by centroid? In triangle ABC, there are three medians which are drawn. One is AD, second median is BE, and the third median is CF. Okay, there are three medians of the triangle. Three medians of the triangle meet at one common point G. Okay, so the point where the three medians meet each other, that point is called as point of concurrence. So point of concurrence is G. Okay, so that point G, that is the point of concurrence, is also called as the centroid of the triangle. So G is also called, point G is also called a centroid of the triangle. Now suppose I take this median AD. Okay, I take median AD. So if I take median AD, I can see that now median AD is divided into two parts. One is AG, another one is GD. But if you see, one part is bigger than the another one. So that means AG, the length of AG is 2 times the length of GD. So I can say AG is twice of GD. Okay, because AG is greater than GD. So I can say AG is twice GD. Same way for BE, I can say BG is twice GE. And for CF also I can say CG is twice of GF. Okay, so that means I can write that as AG upon GD is 2 upon 1, because it divides in the ratio of 2 is to 1. So the centroid divides the median in the ratio of 2 is to 1. So even for BG and GE, BG upon GE is equals to 2 upon 1, and CG upon GF is also 2 upon 1. So it divides the ratio in the it divides the median in the ratio of 2 is to 1. Okay, now let us see the theorem on page number 38. The theorem: in a right angle triangle, okay, so you can see in triangle ABC, ABC is a right angle triangle. So in right angle triangle, the length of the median, okay, so BD is a median, okay, the length of the median of the hypotenuse is half the length of the hypotenuse. So what I have to say, what I have to prove, I have to prove that the length of the median, so this length of median, that is BD, is half of the entire hypotenuse AC. That I have to prove it. So now we have to begin with the proof. We have to draw construction. Okay, so take a point E on ray BD. Okay, so I have extended ray BD to point E. Okay, such that B dash D dash E and length BD and length DE are equal. Okay, and then I draw length EC. So now I will begin with the proof. So I take triangle ABD and triangle DEC. These two triangles I have taken. Now in triangle ABD and triangle CDE, Segment AD and segment CD, both are equal. They have already given us. Why? Because D is a midpoint. BD is the median. So D is the midpoint. So AD and DC are equal. Okay. So you can see I have written segment AD is congruent to segment CD. Next, angle ADB and angle EDC. You can see these two angles. They are vertically opposite angles. Okay. So I have written vertically opposite angle. And the last one is segment BD is congruent to segment D, that is by construction. So the two triangles are congruent by SAS test. Okay. Next, we got the two triangles congruent. So we are going to suppose to write the corresponding angles and corresponding side of the congruent triangle. So let us see which are the corresponding angles and corresponding sides. So now I have stated the two triangles congruent, right? So I can say that angle BAD and angle ECD are congruent, okay, and segment AB and segment EC are also congruent. So this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. Okay, so I got two angles congruent, that is BAD and DCE. Okay, and the other one I got it as the segment congruent, which is AB is congruent to CE. Next, so now we can see BAD and DCE, they form alternate angles. So if they form alternate angles, I can say that AB is parallel to CE. Okay, so I have written AB parallel to EC. Now, I take BC as a transversal. Okay, BC is a transversal. So if you take BC as a transversal, you get angle ABC plus angle ECB. Okay, angle ABC plus angle ECB is equals to 180. Why 180? Because they form a interior angles. Okay, so angle ABC plus angle BC is equals to 180 degree interior angles. But angle ABC is already given to us as 90, because angle B is given 90, right? So B is 90 plus angle ECB is equals to 180. Therefore, I can prove that angle ECB is also 90. So what we proved? We proved this angle as 90. We were not knowing whether it is 90 or not, because we have drawn the angle with the help of construction. Okay, so we got that angle as 90. Now we take triangle ABC. Okay, we take this triangle ABC and triangle EBC. These two right angle triangles we take. Okay, so now in triangle ABC and triangle ECB, AB is congruent to EC. From here we got, right? So from 2 I got, right? Then angle ABC and angle ECB. Okay, angle ABC and angle EBC, ECB, both are 90 degree. We got this is 90 and here we proved this also 90. So both are 90 and BC is a common side. So the two triangles are congruent by side angle side test. Okay, so now what we need to prove? We need to prove BD is half of AC. So we'll take corresponding sides directly because we need a side. Okay, so now So I will write the corresponding sides. That means now AC is congruent to BE. Why I take AC is congruent to BE? Because I need BD and I need AC. Okay, but BD is half of BE, right? BD is half of BE. Okay, so therefore, but BE is equal to AC we got here. So in place of BE, I can substitute as AC. So I got BD is half of AC. Okay, children, you can copy this proof in your notebook, because here they have not given you the entire proof. You can copy it down. Now let us proceed further to practice set 3.3. The first question. Find the values of x and y using the information shown in the figure. Find the measures of angle ABD and angle ACD. Now you can see, children, they have given us certain measures in the figure. So using those measures, we have to find the values of x and y. So now first, in triangle ABC, okay, in triangle ABC, AB and AC are equal, that is given to us. Since these two are equal, okay, it forms an isosceles triangle, right? So if two sides are equal, the opposite angles to them are also equal. That means I can say angle ABC and angle ACB is also equal. That is by isosceles triangle theorem. So you can see over here, I have written AB congruent to AC given the two angles congruent, that is by isosceles triangle theorem. Now, one angle is 50, so the angle will be also 50. So, X is equals to 50. Okay, then next, second sum. We have to find the value of Y also, right? Okay, now in triangle DBC. In triangle DBC, BD and DC is congruent. So if these two angles are congruent, the opposite angle, that means angle DBC and angle DCB are also congruent. So if this is 60, angle Y is also 60 degree. Okay, same way like how we have done to find the value of X. Now we have to find the measure of angle ABD. Now angle ABD is angle ABC plus angle CBD, right? That is by angle addition property. We add these two angles, we get a bigger angle. So I have written angle ABD is angle ABC plus angle DBC. Okay, so now we got angle ABC, that is X, as 50 degree, and angle DBC 60 given. So 50 plus 60 is equals to 110 degree. Now we have to find the measure of angle ACD. Same way, ACD is ACB plus BCD. So you add these two angles, that is 50 plus 60 is also equals to 110. So by using angle addition property, we got the measure of angle ACD is also 110. So this is the first sum. Okay, now let us move further. Okay, let us see the second sum, the second question. The second question, look into your book, into your textbook. The second question is, the length of hypotenuse of a right angle triangle is 15. Okay, the length, okay, what they have given us, the length of hypotenuse of a right angle triangle. So ABC is a right angle triangle and the length of this entire AC, that is the hypotenuse, is 15. Find the length of the median of its hypotenuse. So I have to find this BD. Okay, so now in triangle ABC, angle ABC is 90, right? BD is the median of on the hypotenuse AC. So if BD is a median, I can say that BD is half of AC. Okay, I will say that BD is half of AC. Why do I say that BD is half of AC? Because we have seen a theorem where it states that in a right angle triangle, the median drawn on hypotenuse is half of the hypotenuse. So that means half of 15 is 7.5. So you get the answer of BD as 7.5. Next, the third question, in triangle PQR, let us see the third one. Okay, in triangle PQR, PQ is 12, QR is 5, and angle Q is 90. Find length QS, where QS is a median. So we can say it is a right angle triangle. PQR is a right angle triangle, where angle Q is 90 degree. So I can directly start using Pythagoras theorem. That is PR square is equals to PQ square plus QR square. Okay, where PR I don't know, PQ is 12, QR is 5. So 12 square plus 5 square. So PR square is equals to 144 plus 25, which is equals to 169. Therefore, PR is square root of 169 is 13 units. So length, that is QS, is the median on hypotenuse PR. So QS is half of PR, right? We have to find QS, but we got PR. But QS is the median on PR, which is the hypotenuse. So QS is half of PR. So QS is half of 13, which is equals to 6.5. So we get the length of median QS is 6.5 units. Okay. Fourth question. Look into your textbook. In the figure, point G is the point of concurrence of the medians of triangle PQR. So you can see there are three medians. Okay, and point G is the point of concurrence of three medians. GT is 2.5. So this GT is given to us as, segment GT is given to us as 2.5. Find the length of PG, okay, and this entire PT. We have to find the length of PG and PT. Now, they have already given to us that in triangle PQR, G is a centroid. Right? So, if G is a centroid in the given triangle, then PG upon GT is in the ratio of 2 is to 1. Because centroid divides the median in the ratio of 2 is to 1. So, PG upon GT is equals to 2 upon 1. But we know the value of GT, that is 2.5. So PG upon GT is 2.5. So in place of GT, I write the value of GT as 2.5, which is equals to 2 upon 1. Therefore, PG is equals to 2 into 2.5, which is equals to 5 centimeter. So we got the value for PG. Now we need to find the value for PT. So PT is PG plus GT. So PT is equals to PG plus GT, which is equals to 2.5 plus 5, because PG is 5. So how we are going to add? Now it is 5 and the other one is 2.5. Now 5 doesn't have a point, so you will put a point and add a 0. So this is the way you are going to add it. Okay, this is your answer. Some of you will do like this, 2.5 plus 5, which is wrong. Okay, so this is the way you have to add when you get one decimal point and no number, another number without a decimal point. So you have to put a point and add a 0 if there is no decimal point. So your answer is 7.5. Okay, next. Perpendicular bisector theorem, page 39 of your textbook. Okay, let's see. Every point on the perpendicular bisector of a segment is equidistant from the endpoints of the segment. Every point on perpendicular bisector. Okay? Every point on perpendicular bisector. So AB, segment AB, on segment AB, line L is a perpendicular bisector of segment AB. Okay? At point M. Okay? So what I have to prove, that it is equidistant from the endpoints of the segment. So I have to prove PA and PB are at equal distance. So they are equal. I have to prove PA and PB equal. Okay. So I draw construction, draw segment AP and segment BP. So you get two triangles, triangle APM and triangle PBM. Okay. Now in these two triangles, we know AM and MB are equal because M is a M is a point of perpendicular bisector. So it divides AB into two equal parts. So AM and MB are equal. So I have written AN and MB equal, that is given. Then PM is a common side for both the triangles. So one is a common side and one is a right angle. That is angle PMA and angle PME. Both are equal because they are right angle. So the two triangles are congruent by side angle side test. Okay. So the two triangles are congruent by side angle side test. Now I will write the corresponding side. So I get PA and PB as congruent sides of, corresponding sides of congruent angles. So segment PA is congruent to segment PB. So length of PA and PB are equal. So I have proved. Next, that was part one of the proof. Now let us see the second part of the proof, part two. Any point equidistant from the endpoints of the segment. Now this is a converse of the previous one. Okay, it is a converse. Any point equidistant. Now earlier we have proved the two segment. That means I have proved P and PB equal. Now here they have given us that the two segments are equal. P and PB are equal, and I have to prove that point P is on the perpendicular bisector of segment AB. Okay, that is I have to proof. So now I do the construction. Okay, now to do construction I have to take a midpoint M on segment AB and draw a line PM. Okay, now you get a triangle APM and triangle PMB where segment PA and PB are equal. That is given to us. Okay, it is given. Then segment AM and segment BM, both are also equal. Why? We get with the help of a construction. They have not told us that it is a perpendicular bisector. We have drawn a construction there. Okay, so with the help of a construction I can say that AM and BM are equal. So by construction. And last, PM is a common side. So two triangles are congruent by side test. So if they are congruent by side test, I can take angle PMA and angle PMB as equal angles. Okay, so those are corresponding angles of congruent triangles. But angle PMA and angle PMB, okay, angle PMA plus angle PMB is equals to 180, right? Angle PMA plus angle PMB is equals to 180 degree. Okay, because they form a linear pair. So now, therefore angle PMA plus angle PMA again. Why? Because angle PMB and angle PMA both are equal. Okay, angle PMB and angle PMA equal. So in place of PMB, I will write PMA is equals to 180. So one angle PMA plus one angle PMA gives you two angle PMA is equals to 180. So angle PMA is 90. So I can say PM is perpendicular to AB. So that means point M. Okay. So I can say PM is perpendicular to AB. But point M is midpoint of segment AB. So I can say that line PM is perpendicular bisector of segment AB. Okay. Next, angle bisector theorem. Page number 40. Every point on the bisector of an angle is equidistant from the sides of the angle. What is the statement? Every point on the bisector of an angle is equidistant from the sides of the angle. So what I have to prove? I have to prove PM and PN are equal. Why they equal? Because every point on the bisector of an angle, so BD is angle bisector. So every point, so point P is equidistant from point M and from point N. So I have to prove PM and PN are equal. Now what is given? Ray BD bisects angle ABC. Okay, point P is on ray BD. Now PM is perpendicular to ray BA and PN is perpendicular to ray BC. I have to prove PM and PN are equal. Now, in triangle PMB and triangle PNB, in these two triangles, okay, PNB and PMB, side PB is a common side for both the triangles. So common side. Then angle PBM and angle PPN. Both the angles are congruent. Why? Because those two angles are formed with the help of a angle bisector. Okay, that is formed by ray BD. Okay, so ray BD bisects angle ABC. So with the help of that, I got those two angles congruent. And the third angle is angle M and angle N also congruent, that is 90. So the two triangles are congruent by side angle angle test. Okay, so similar, so if I get this congruent by SAA test, I can take PM and PN as the corresponding sides of congruent triangle. So it is proved that PM is equals to PN. Okay, next, let us see the next theorem. Any point equidistant from the sides of an angle is on the bisector of the angle. Okay, any point equidistant from the angle, or sorry, from the sides of an angle. So now you have to prove that point A, that means ray QA is a bisector of angle PQR. I have to prove that. Okay, they have given us that BA and AC are equidistant. They are equal. Okay, in angle PQR, AB and AC are equal. Okay, and AB is perpendicular to ray QR. AC is perpendicular to ray QR and AB is perpendicular to ray QP. And I have to prove that ray QD is a bisector of angle PQR. So now, let us see the proof. In triangle BAQ and triangle AQC, okay, one angle is already 90. So I have written 90. Now if this is a 90, it is a right angle triangle. So if it is a right angle triangle, QA is the hypotenuse side, right? So QA is a common side, that is a hypotenuse. QA is congruent to hypotenuse QA, that is common side. Okay, and the last one is BA is congruent to AC, that is given to us. So the two triangles are congruent by hypotenuse side test, because there is a hypotenuse side. Since it is a angle of 90 degree, we get a hypotenuse side. So the two triangles are congruent by hypotenuse side test. So after that, I will write the corresponding side, that is angle BQA and angle CQA are congruent, corresponding angle of congruent triangle. But angle BQA lies in angle PQA, or I can say PQD, okay? But angle BQA lies in angle PQA. So in place of BQA, I have written PQA, and angle CQA lies in angle RQA. That means ray QA, okay, ray QA is the angle bisector of angle PQR. That has been proved. Okay, next. Properties of inequalities of sides and angles of a triangle. Okay, let's see. If two sides of a triangle are unequal, okay, if two sides of a triangle are unequal, okay, they have given us any two sides are unequal, then the angle opposite to the greater side is greater and angle opposite to smaller side is smaller. So I have to prove that the angle opposite to greater side is greater and the angle opposite to smaller side is smaller. So let us see the proof in triangle XYZ. Now, two sides of a triangle are unequal. Okay, they are not equal. So suppose side XZ is greater than side XY. You can see XZ is greater than XY. Okay, suppose it is, they have given this. Now what I have to prove? I have to prove that angle XYZ, okay, that is side opposite to greater, angle opposite to greater side. So which is angle opposite to greater, now XZ is greater side. So angle opposite to XZ is angle XYZ and angle opposite to smaller side is angle XZY. Okay, so XYZ and XZY, okay, these are the two angles. Okay, so I have to prove angle XYZ is greater than angle XZY. So you have to do a construction. Take a point P on side XZ. Okay, so I have taken a point P on side XZ such that xy and xp are equal. Okay, so these two sides are equal. So I have drawn a segment yp. So you take a triangle xyp. In triangle xyp, xy and xp are equal. Okay, by construction. So this is an isosceles triangle. So if the two sides are equal, the angle opposite to them also equal. That means angle xyp and angle xpy both are equal. That is isosceles triangle theorem. That is equation 1. But angle xpy is an exterior angle of triangle pyz. Okay, angle xpy is exterior angle of triangle pyz. Okay, so that means the exterior angle xpy is greater than the interior angles. Okay, so xpy, okay, is greater than angle pzy. Exterior angle theorem, xpy is greater than pzy. Okay, but xpy is equals to xyp. So in place of xpy, I can write as xyp is greater than angle pzy. That is from, I get from equation 1. Right? So now, I can write that as angle xyp, okay, plus angle pyz, okay, is greater than angle pzy. Okay, that means if A is greater than B and C is greater than 0, then A plus C is greater than B. Okay, angle XYP, okay, plus angle P, angle XYP plus angle PYZ, okay, that is, this is the third angle C, is greater than angle PZY. Okay, therefore now angle XYP plus angle PYZ is angle XYZ. You add these two angles, you get the entire angle XYZ. So in place of these two angles, I can write as angle XYZ is greater than angle PZY. Okay, that is what we have to proof. Okay, but angle PZY lies in angle XZY, so in place of PZY I can write as XZY. That is the proof. Next, if two angles of a triangle are unequal, okay, if two angles of a triangle are unequal, then side opposite to the greater angle is greater than the side opposite to smaller angle. So what is given to us? Angle in triangle ABC, angle B and C, okay, where angle B is greater than angle C, that is given, and I have to prove that side opposite to greater angle is greater and side opposite to smaller angle is smaller. So I have to prove AC is greater than AB. Okay, now there are three possibilities where we can prove AC is greater than AB. Now the first possibility, I can say that AC is smaller than AB. Second is AC is equals to AB. And the third one is AC is greater than AB. So let us take the first possibility. AC is AC is smaller than AB. So now suppose AC is smaller than AB. So if two sides of a triangle are unequal, the angle opposite to the greater side is greater. So that means angle C is greater than angle B. Okay? Angle C is greater than angle B. Next, but angle C is smaller than angle B. Okay? Angle C is smaller than angle B. That is according to the given thing. Because what is given? Angle B is greater than angle C. So what we have written, angle C is, but we have written what? According to this, angle C is greater than angle B. But what is given? It is given that angle C is smaller than angle B. That means angle B is greater than angle C. So it proves a contradiction that AC is not, that means AC greater than AB is wrong. Okay, then second, AC is equals to AB. Okay, AC is equals to AB. So if AC is equals to AB, then both the angles opposite to them are also equal. Angle B and angle C are equal. Okay, but angle B is greater than angle C, that is given to us. So this creates a contradiction to AC is equals to AB is wrong. So what is the last possibility? AC is greater than AB is the only possibility which is correct. Okay, so we'll stop over here. And for homework, you have to solve these sums from the problem set. Question 2, question 7 and question 4. Thank you.